All right, hello. I need to readjust some things here behind the scenes so my computer doesn't blow up. You probably heard my voice getting a bit close to the microphone. I apologize with that. Yeah, how has it been? How long has it been since the last stream? 8 days? Really? It almost felt like it has been longer. I apologize for not having, for not doing some streams. I felt like I really just needed the time off, you know? We don't want to burn out anyone here, so I just figured we might as well. Today, we have a very special game in store for you guys. We have Hollow Knight. I'm not sure whether or not Silksong is out anymore, or out just yet. I feel like it is? I'm not sure. How are the frames, by the way? It looked like my display, my preview, is jittering quite a bit. That might be just something on my end. What if I change display mode here? Oh, there we go. That looks a lot better. Okay, lovely. Yeah, so we're going to be playing Hollow Knight today. I wanted to play a story-based or story-driven game today, but the games I wanted to play, which was Final Fantasy X or X-2, I didn't quite figure out exactly which one I wanted to play. That one wasn't installed on my computer, even though Steam said it was. So I'm having it verify the integrity of the game files in the background, and reacquiring all the files. It is gonna take an hour. So I figured I might as well start off with playing this. This is probably the closest thing I have to a story-based game that I have on at the ready, I think. There's another game, Okami, as well, that I have currently going on. Let me move this over to the screen so I'm not constantly looking over there. There we go. How's that? Is this more personable to you guys? Now that I'm not, like, looking all the way over here? Well. Alright. But yeah, I also have new lighting set up. I literally just have... Let me grab this and show you. So this is my desk, right? I literally just had, oh, that is blazing bright. I didn't realize that would come out so brightly on the camera. but yeah, I've literally just taken a lamp from my living room and have placed it on my desk because I am a professional and I know what I am doing. I felt like the light coming up from up there. I have a light. Let's see if we can show it. There we go. That thing right there. As you can see, the lampshade there is actually like just metal bars, so it doesn't really like create a shade at all. It just like lets all the light out through, and honestly I don't know what its purpose is. Probably to avoid you from looking directly at the light, but it really doesn't help with that. Anyway, how has your days been going, Twitch chat and everyone on YouTube? I hope you are all being or having a wonderful time. I hope your day is, let me see. How would I phrase this? I want to say something positive about your experience watching the stream and how hopeful I am that the stream is going to benefit you guys. This video is going to benefit you guys in some way. But honestly, I don't know what the words are. So we're just going to go with what I said. All right, let's go ahead and get ourselves into this. So I have played this game, as you can see, I have a 54-hour stream right here. Oh, am I limited at 30 frames per second? Is there a way that I can upgrade this? Give me 1 second here. Stream? Output? Can I upgrade the FPS? Streaming... Oh, video, here we go. Oh, I can't change the value. Interesting. Hopefully this looks okay on stream. It seems like on my actual Twitch preview, not the one in OBS, it looked like it's going fine, so... I will leave it like that. I will investigate whether or not I can get it up to 60 frames per second a bit later. But for now, we are gonna go and start off a new game. I do love this game. We're playing classic mode. We don't want to stress ourselves out too much with Steel Soul. But yeah. In the wilds, they speak your name with reverence and regret, for none could tame our savage souls, and yet you the challenge met. Under palest watch you taught we changed, base instincts were redeemed, a world you gave to a bug and beast as they had never dreamed. From Elegy of Hallownest by Monomon the Teacher. Ooh, interesting. That is a great way to establish a setting, right? Already, like, up to this point, so we've been introduced to, like, this melancholic music from the title screen. We've been introduced to a quote by a mysterious person hinting about vagaries of a society and of you. And now we have this. Ooh. How's the volume? Is the volume okay? I'm going to get to a battle and keep an eye on the desktop audio bar and see how it turned out. Alright, so here we are. We have... Oh? Why is it pausing? One second. Hopefully that was just a minor bug. Alright, and here we go. We have our hero of the story. This is us. And here we go. Descending down into whatever this thing is. I'm gonna alt tab here quickly. Here we go. Oh, is this, I hope everything is going okay in terms of the graphics. Is this fine? One second, I need to actually check my Twitch to see if this is actually fine or not. Let's see. It seems like it's a little jumpy. Is it jumpy to you guys, or is that just my screen preview acting up? I'm actually going to quickly check this out on my phone. Because I feel like this is going to affect the viewing experience if this is, if this doesn't go well. Let's go to here. Can I actually watch my own stream? Hello? Can I... my channel. Yes, let's check this out. Oh, what? This is a bit strange. Hold on a second. What is going on here? How'd my stream statistics doing? Am I dropping any frames? Oh, I have one issue. What is this? Skipped frames detected 26% over the last 2 minutes. Some frames have not been encoded. This problem is usually due to high CPU usage or unsuitable encoder settings. Lower encoder settings. Make sure you don't have any other applications open that are heavy on CPU. Oh, interesting. Okay, yeah. We'll get this sorted out briefly. Let's see. Now that I know how to do the clip setting thing on YouTube, I know pretty much system interrupts are taking up like 86%. Of my CPU. That's crazy. Hollow Knight, Steam. Okay, you know what, Steam? I know you're busy doing something in the background. Let's have you stop doing that busy something in the background. Yeah, let's pause that. Will that reduce my CPU usage? Looks like it has. What else is using up a lot of CPU? Google Chrome. Do I have any unnecessary Chrome tabs up? I guess I can get rid of Twitter. Here we go. Now I just have the dashboard, for Streamlabs, and I have Twitch up. Oh, hello there. Oh, I got a follow. Thank you, Mizuki VTuber, for following. I didn't anticipate that. I am, at the moment, I am very much just trying to get my computer to work to handle this. My computer is an ancient device. It's, we actually dug it up in my backyard when we moved in back in about 2008. It was incredible that it still worked considering how degraded and decrepit it was. But once we blew up the dust, once we, you know, got rid of all the worms inside of it, once we cleaned up everything on the interior, it all worked out. We just plugged it in and off we went. okay, let's see. Is this working? Skipped frames detected. Okay, are there any more skipped frames? How's it looking now? It's still looking bad. Is this just something that I can't do on my computer? Yeah, what if... What else is taking up a lot of... Okay, what if I don't want to do it, though. Hold on a moment. Let me take a look at my task manager. CPU usage is at 61%. 50%. It seems like, yeah, the three that I'm using most are Hollow Knight, Google Chrome, and Streamlabs. Ooh, that looks messy. If it can't run these guys normally, then that's not going to be very good now, is it? Let's see. I'm just going to move around a little bit, see if there are any dropped frames. Let's go ahead and do some jumping and some attacking. I don't think it's saying that I'm losing any frames. Let's see. Is it this one? Hold on, which one is it that said I lose frames? None of them, huh? Okay. Let me just take a look at my encoder settings quickly, if I can, if I know how to do that. Output. I have no idea how to do that. Stream? Output? Encoder settings? Recording audio? Nope, not there. Nope. Video? Oh, audio? Recording? No, it's not here. Ah, okay, no, I can't find it. Notifications, scene settings. No. Interesting. Okay, let's see. Can I move my character okay? I'm checking my stream. It looks like I'm still dropping frames. That is terrible. Why am I dropping frames still? Hold up. Let's take a look at the stream. Okay, stream. It still doesn't look too good, honestly. It looked like it's still jumpy all over the place. Oh man, it might be that I can't actually play Hollow Knight. Not with the setup I currently have. What would I need? I'd need a better GPU. Let me take a look at my performances here. Memory. CPU is at 69%. GPU. Yeah, my GPU settings are at like 99%. Ooh, okay, so maybe I can't get away with playing Hollow Knight, which is hilarious. Okay, so if that's the case then, what will we play? I'm gonna give it a little bit more of a... Yeah, I'm still skipping like a butt ton of frames here. Ugh, that sucks. Lower your encoder settings preset. Ensure you don't have enabled performance mode in the editor context menu. I don't even know what the editor context menu is. Let's see, virtual webcam, nope. Virtual, is that the thing that VTubers use? The virtual webcam? Is it in advanced? Video? I'm really not sure where these encoder settings are set. Let's find out. Twitch encoder settings. OBS. I do apologize. Let's see. Yeah, but how do I change my encoder setting? I have no idea how to change my encoder settings. Oh man, yeah, I am still skipping frames like mad. Okay, let's go over to the intermission screen just now. And I think I'm gonna have to put up a... I don't have a difficulty, a troubleshooting difficulty thing. Let's get... no, not that one. Be right back. No, I'm still here. Let's leave it on here for now. And I guess I'm gonna type in... No, probably not. Skip frame detected, 26% over the... Oh man, come on. Open settings. Yeah, come on. Show me where all of this stuff, where all the details are. Confirm stream title, configured default devices, output. Source alignment snapping. I have no idea what I'm even pressing. That is my my microphone and my webcam. Yeah, open settings, please. Give me back my settings. I cannot change settings while I'm live. Oh boy. Wait, hold on. Recording? No, that's not the one. So it might be that I have to use something else, huh? Probably gonna have to play a different game. Either that, or actually, oh, what if we... Nope, not those ones. I want to, is it video? Yeah, it's probably in video. Resolution. Let's turn it off full screen and let's, sure, let's try that. Does that help at all? If we change the resolution down? I'm literally not seeing any difference. Okay, windowed. If we go into windowed mode, how did this work? Has that changed the... Yeah, that has changed the size of it on stream. Here we go. Is this better? And if we keep it like this... Yeah, let's readjust here. Oh no, oh, come on. I didn't hit the save, the apply? Keep resolution? Yeah. Yeah, I said yeah, okay. Alright, give me a moment here, things are gonna move around on stream a little bit. Oh man, this is not something I had expected. One port of call for you guys. Reduce to improve performance on lower end machines. Particle effects, sure. Okay, how are the frames now? ...26% over the last 2 minutes. We've been streaming for 21 minutes already? Oh my goodness. Live tab. Zero dropped frames currently. Okay, let's hit the continue button and let's see if we have any upsets. Is this going to work? Look like I'm not getting any skipped frames. How does it look on stream? Let me take a look at my stream preview. Come on, hold on. Can I... Yeah, let's see how this looks on the stream preview. Oh, it's looking so good! Oh, I love it! Okay. I am happy. I am very happy. So, I just need to turn down the quality a little bit. Okay, hold on. Let's head back to the live scene. There we go. Okay, is this gonna work? Oh, it looks, I can see that it's 30 frames per second, but it looks good. Okay, we're ready to continue. Okay, well, we are back. We have sorted out the troubleshooting issue. There may still be some issues regarding the stream, regarding skipped frames, and give me a second here to address this one here. Yeah, Okay, and am I getting any missed frames? No, lovely. Okay, we are good to go. Okay, so people on YouTube, this is probably where the video is going to pick right back up. I spent maybe about 20 minutes or so trying to figure out my encoder settings and the video settings to play this game. But yeah, let's see. So yeah, in terms of like how this game generates an atmosphere, what have we seen already? Well, we were introduced to the title screen, right? And the title screen had this very melancholic music against like a dark background with the light coming from the top of it, right? That kind of suggests that there's a well, that suggests some of the themes, right? Let's see, interact. Higher beings, these words are for you alone. Your great strength marks you amongst us. Focus your soul, and you shall achieve feats of which others can only dream. Ooh, I like that. Dude, that's such a the hint that such that others can only dream, for which others can only dream. I love that. That's great foreshadowing. That's stuff that I would love to be able to do in D&D. Be able to foreshadow things like that. But with foreshadowing, you need to know where you're going, basically. You need to know what like the I don't know how to explain it. Oh, I forgot that thing was there. But you need to foreshadow. In order to foreshadow, you need to have an idea of where like the campaign is, going, or at least the quest line that you're on, like what the end of the game is going to be, right? Like you need to have things prepared in the future. Ooh, take a look at this. And I feel like when it comes to D&D, at least when I plan D&D, it's lose one of those hearts immediately. Well done. At least when I plan D&D, it's not exactly, I plan for what's needed at the time, right? I've only recently started this. When I say recently, I mean in the past, like 5 or 6 months or so. Ooh. In the past 5 or 6 months or so, actually planning out what precisely, I don't know how to describe it, but like I plan out the entire quest basically, right? It's like, let's say, let me think of a good example. I'll try and think of a good example while we continue on with this. Higher beings, these words are for you alone. Beyond this point, you enter the land of the King and Creator. Step across this threshold and obey our laws. Bear witness to the last and only civilization, the Eternal Kingdom, Hallownest. All right. Look at that. The implication of light radiating through, that is a sign of, good foreshadowing. And it's not even bright on this side. Ooh. But yeah, lately when it comes to planning D&D quests, what I've started doing is started writing the basic, quest line from start to finish. Whatever the party does from that point on, or in the interim period, is up to them. Then I change things based on how they react, which I think is probably the best way to go about it. Oh there, traveler. I'm afraid there's only me left to offer welcome. Our town's fallen quiet, you see. The other residents, they've all disappeared. Headed down that well one by one into the caverns below. Used to be there was a great kingdom beneath our town. It's long fell to ruin, yet it still draws folks into its depths. Wealth, glory, enlightenment, that darkness seemed to promise all things. I'm sure you too seek your dreams down there. Well, watch out. It's a sickly air that fills the place. Creatures turn mad and travelers are robbed of their memories. Perhaps dreams aren't such great things after all. I love that, like, one of the ideas I'm getting from this is almost like this place used to be great, right? And what is it? The way that this guy speaks with it. Was it this guy? Many used to come hoping the kingdom would fulfill their desires. So, yeah, this guy mentioned, like, this kingdom was great in its past, right? This kingdom was, the place to be in the past. Hallownest, it was once called, supposedly the greatest kingdom there ever was, full of treasures and secrets. So we have greatest kingdom, we have treasures and secrets. Now it's nothing more than a poisonous tomb full of monsters and madness. Makes you really, like, this bears the question, what happened to Hallownest? Everything fades eventually, I suppose. Yeah. So we have a few buildings around here that we can't really interact with. For all your mapping supplies, we'll be opening soon, Iselda and Cornifer. Lovely. And we have a well here, but we're going to jump over that just now. We're going to just move on and see what else we have. Inspect. A stone door with a simple lock. Okay, so we have a key that we can find somewhere. We have this altar here, which I think is going to be useful later. It's been a long time since I played this game. So my memory is not going to be quite what it was, even though I've got, like, you know, over, what is that, 70 hours in this game. I really just need to refresh my memory on most of the things that are happening. Alright, and here we have a large building with light, and it's already been foreshadowed a couple of times that there is something up with light in this game. From the title screen, you saw the light bearing down on you, like a light from above shining down. From that wall that we broke through to get into Hallownest, we had those light beams shining out. So now this is, you know, Temple of the Black Egg. And we have a mysterious guy here. Hello there! How delightful to meet another traveller on these forgotten roads. You're a short one, but you've got a strong look about you. I'm Quirrell. I have something of an obsession with uncharted places. This ancient kingdom holds many fascinating mysteries, and one of the most intriguing one of them is standing right before us. A great stone egg lying in the corpse of an ancient kingdom. And this egg, is it warm? It certainly gives off a unique air. Can it be opened? There are strange marks all over it. I do so love a mystery, and who knows what other marvels lie even deeper below us. So yeah, we have Quirrell here. He is the second NPC that we meet. Makes me think that he might be a bit important, right? We've only had two opportunities to interact with other people. One of them was the guy in the town, the Elderbug, and then we have this guy. For so long, I felt drawn here. So many tales full of wonders and horrors. No longer could I resist. I just had to see it for myself. And what a time I chose to arrive. This dead world had sprung to life. The creatures are all riled up and the earth rumbles. The air is thick. I wonder, what could have brought it all about? To preserve in this ruin, that old nail alone won't be enough. Though that's no problem. Only one has to look around. Plenty have come before us, and most have met their grisly end, many more equipped than you and I. I'm sure they wouldn't mind were a fellow explorer to relieve them of their tools. It's a kindness, really. The dead shouldn't be burdened with such things. Ooh, we get some information about the dead. Did you pass that town above? What a gloomy little place, and such majesty hidden right beneath. I suppose that's why they've all headed down here. Who could resist such possibilities? Truly a marvel. Yeah, so NPCs in this game also have more than two dialogue choices. I probably could have explored some more dialogue from the dude. Actually, we can go back and get the dude, right? I'm sure we can do that a bit later. But for now, let's take a look to see what we have. Now look at this. What makes this a good environment? I have no idea. We have, like, you know, things like this wagon here. Look at it. I mean, can't look at it anymore. But that was a wagon and it had like an insectoid shell on it. That hints that there is like thought that goes into the world building here, right? Like these creatures aren't just like normal creatures like you and I. They don't just have wagons. They have wagons shaped in snail shells, right? And we also have these strange, mindless creatures that we're not really sure why they're attacking us. They're not even attacking us, they're just minding their own business, honestly. And we're just going around killing them. But that's more of a player choice thing than a necessary lore thing, right? Alright. Yeah, so we have an upset person up here. He looked pretty elderly. And even without a hint of dialogue, we can see that there are, like, he's in one of them, right? That implies that this is where he lives. And we can see many more of these eggs, basically, around him. And they're all empty, and he's crying because of it. Immediately, we can tell this guy is upset because he is lonely, right? Maybe his family has been separated from him. So, yeah, that's a great... And we can even see, like, more of it in the background. This is amazing. Alright, we'll keep him in mind for later. In the meanwhile, we can begin descending down here to this mysteriously great city. Well, there's a dead bug there. That's probably the one that we just killed. Alright. Oh. We're also getting used to how this game is going to be, you know, played, right? We're getting used to the experience of the game. We're doing a lot of platforming to get down here. We have some minor enemies here who are extremely predictable. And then we get a little bit more variety. That one looked like it was a person. But you notice they had strange orange coloration in their eyes. I love how this game, seems. Oh, and take a look at that. We can now see that we have someone over here who looks very suspiciously like that old caterpillar gentleman. And we can see... that he's trapped. Now let's go ahead and reload the screen here. We're going to try and bounce off of an enemy to reach that thing. Alright, let's see if we can get this done. Do we have a flying creature that we can bounce off of? There's a flying creature up here that we can use. I guess we're gonna have to... Oh. This doesn't look like it's gonna be easy. Yeah, no, we won't be able to get up here in time to... Nope, okay. That's fine. Oh, come on. I'm really not paying attention here. The one time I turned to look at chat. Alright, we have another person. So, there are still a few unanswered questions here. Obviously. We've only just started. There's going to be unanswered questions. But, like, namely, who are we, right? That's probably going to be... I guess the implication is we are here because we've been drawn to this great town, right? We came from the outside and we found this place. And yeah. Did you visit that temple? A strange building, I've heard, though I'd never dared the journey myself. The braver among us once went there to pray, said they felt at peace within the walls. After a while, they stopped going. I wonder what changed. Feeling tired? That bench may be iron, but I assure you it's quite comfortable. There's no better place to collect your thoughts before heading below. Plus, I enjoy the company. Not that you seem the talkative sort. Alright. So yeah, it seems like every time we die, we come back at one of those benches. Ooh. Oh, is he not open yet? Which is interesting, isn't it? How does this bench save our progress, right? What is the narrative purpose of that bench? You know, that might sound a bit crazy, right? But, no, I feel like it's... I don't even know. We come back from the benches, but we also leave behind a shade. What my original point was going to be, or my original suggestion, is it feels like you're just waking up from a daydream. Which goes with the theme of dreams in this game. But at the same time, we actually leave behind, like, a physical shade when we die. Let's see if we can find it. I believe we died around here. Yeah, there's our shade. Ooh. Alright, there we go. We're now getting a bit more enemy variety here. And what are these things in the background? Right? Are they coffins or something? I don't think they are. They're definitely cocoons. I feel like bugs, you know, cocoon themselves. So I don't feel like it implies death at all. But it's certainly strange. There's clearly been a lot of thought that goes into the environment here. Because shells in the background. It's only, like, really relevant for... Not relevant, but, like, only in the Hollow Knight, right? These textures here were made with a purpose. And if we can get some more of this in Silksong, I don't care how long it takes the developers to make, honestly. If we get something that is as high quality as this game from Silksong, I don't care if it takes them another 2 years, another 5 years to make it. It'll be worth it in the end. Before we head on down, let's go ahead and check our sides. So right now, we don't really have a reason for going exploring, right? It's not like we're down here trying to find something specific. We're just down here exploring. That is the open invitation, right? For some reason, we are here to explore. We don't quite know exactly why we're here to explore. Hopefully that'll be made known to us at a later point, but also at the same time, I don't think we need to know, right? I feel like just the implication that we're here simply exploring this location is all that we need. Wait, we're back here? Is Quirrell still here? Yeah, Quirrell's still here. Yeah, he has nothing else to say. Okay. Didn't realize that looped around. And yeah, this game is a Metroidvania game. So we're going to be getting, if you're not familiar with Hollow Knight, we're going to be getting some upgrades as we explore. But yeah, I feel like the nameless... Ooh. Oh. Yeah, this guy deals... What is it? Two... Oh. Ah, hold on, okay. Combat is gonna get busy here. But once you know what to look out for, it's just a matter of keeping up the pattern. Ah! Hello there, friend. We have rescued our first little guy. Lovely. Okay, I have no idea why he was guarding that, but whatever. Nothing needs explanation, honestly. Let's heal ourselves up. There we go. That leads to the Temple of the Black Egg. So we can just head on down here. And it looked like we're going into some sort of mine. Yeah, there are crystals here. Oh, this bug. Hey there, buddy. Oh, bury my mother pale and slight. Bury my father with his eyes shut tight. Bury my sisters two by two. And then when you're done, let's bury me too. Do you know that one? It's one of my favorites. We can sing something else if you like. You start singing and I'll join in. I bet you have a beautiful singing voice. So, what are you down here for? If you came to get wealthy, just look around you. These mines are filled to bursting with riches. There's plenty for everyone. Just pick and grab and join in. Just grab a pick and join in. Oh. Oh, bury the knight with her broken nail. Bury the priest. Something about a crown? I can't remember the rest of that one. Maybe I'll just hum it. Yeah, so we meet, what's her name? Myla here. So Myla is just mining down here. She's just, you know, innocently mining her own business. She's friendly. She's a bit awkward. But that's a bit more endearing, isn't it? That makes her quite endearing. But we can also sense that there's something slightly not right with her. She's forgetting her songs, she's singing strange songs about burying their mother, burying their father, and their twin sisters. And then about burying her too. Ah! Actually, I don't think this thing is gonna break, is it? Yeah, no, we need an upgrade to break this. Yeah, we don't have access to the upgrade just yet. So I believe this place is currently locked off to us. I feel like there is a way to unlock that right now, but I can't remember exactly what it is. All right, have we gone up here? I feel like, yeah, we have. Yeah, that's where we fought the guy to rescue the worm. Okay, so this whole area here is a bit of a dead end. So let's head on down. All right, we get a little bit more change of scenery, although we are currently locked. Yeah, we're currently locked in, so we can't do anything about this one. Okay. Let's not waste any time. Ho ho ho, love it. The way this game feels is just so nice. The way that it controls the atmosphere, the environment, the sense of discovery as well, it's just great. Absolutely love it. And yeah, I don't think there's a way for us to rescue that little friend up there just yet. Unless we can bounce off and... What we could do is we could die and then bounce off of our shade. But I don't think I'm prepared to do that. At least not yet. Imagine if this was Steel Soul. Okay, we have a sign here. The Pilgrim's Way. Travelers of Hallownest descend through verdant wilds and fungal groves to the city at this kingdom's heart. There all wishes shall be granted, all truths revealed. Yeah, so there is something grand about this city. If I remember right, we can't... Yeah, we need to get the ranged attack. I almost was going to say the ball shooting thingy. Oh! Yeah, let's head up a little bit. We pass by a door up top there. Can we make that jump? Oh, we can't make that jump. Let's give it another go. Let's head up from a little bit higher of a vantage point now. Here we go. Is this a blue heart place? No. Okay, we don't need to do anything there. Let's heal up. And then let's pick up some more soul essence here. Are they actually trying to bump into me or... Ah! Okay, what's going on here? We don't have the wall jump. Am I correct in saying we don't have the wall jump? Yeah, I don't think we have the wall jump. So this direction here is off limits to us for now. Let's take a look at... Oh, we don't have access to the map. That's right, we need to pick up the map. Oof. Okay, so I think we have explored all of the side areas around here. So we can head on down. And here we go. Immediately, we see a friendly face. Hmm? Ah, hello there. Come down to explore these beautiful old ruins. Oh, don't mind me. I have a fondness for exploring myself. Getting lost and finding your way again is a pleasure like no other. We're exquisitely lucky, you and I. I'm a cartographer by trade, and I'm working on mapping this area right now. Would you like to buy a copy of my work so far? Sure. There we go. We now have access to the map. Hold LB. Lovely. A map can be a useful thing, but it alone won't show you where you are. If you've not the head for directions, I suggest purchasing a compass from my wife, Iselda. She's just now opening our new shop in Dirtmile, selling all sorts of useful things to wanderers like yourself. She'll even sell some of my old maps from time to time. I pop back to see her whenever I finish mapping an area. She's always so excited to see me. Oh, by the way, I haven't introduced myself, have I? Yes, I should apologize for that. When you spend a lot of time by yourself just with your own thoughts, you forget the niceties of conversation. I actually had that the other day. I had a friend come visit me, and it's the first time that I've had anyone around in like months, if not maybe like a year or so. I don't really talk to that many people at home. Home is like my space. But we just like sat at the standing at the door for like, you know, 5 minutes or so before I was like, oh no, I'm meant to be the host. Okay, let's go. Let's sit in the lounge. So yeah, my name is Cornifer. Did I say that right? Cornifer. And I've always loved exploring the world. Why, when I was first hatched, I wandered off immediately, leaving my brothers and sisters and my poor mother behind. That's why as soon as I could, I moved to Dirtmouth with my wife. A huge, unending kingdom to explore right on our doorstep. Who could resist? Anyway, I'll let you return to your travels. With a little luck, we'll meet again. Be safe and farewell. Anything else? How are you finding my map? I've tried to fill out as much as I can, but every map is a work in progress. If you'd like to fill out some of the map yourself, you can purchase some mapping supplies from my wife up in Dirtmouth. We've set up a little shop to help make ends meet. Make me wonder about the benefits of setting up a shop up front, up above. How much trade they actually get. We see that we have people like Quirrell and ourselves, of course, who are here. And that's not going to be the only NPCs we'll find. We're going to find some more NPCs. I remember these creatures. Okay, this means we're heading toward the deep nest, right? Yeah, I think so. So the great thing about these guys is you can bounce off them. They are an enemy and a platforming obstacle as well. Ah, come on. All right. Here we go. Okay, we have a new enemy and we have a new obstacle, and that is water. Oh! Ah! That's right, they spawn monsters. Oh! We get another dude! Lovely! I genuinely cannot remember, like, the layout to here. I know there's something under there. I know there's something in that acid that we can go and get, but we can't access it just yet. But in terms of the general layout here, like, I've completely forgotten where everything is. So, even though I've played this before, like, twice or so, this is still going to be a bit of a discovery for us. For myself included. Alright, we have a place where we can get some money. So yeah, we've been introduced to two characters so far. Well, three, I guess. With Quirrell, we know that Quirrell is here because of adventure, right? We've heard him... Oh, and that's a great way to introduce that as well. You accidentally hit it because they know you want to get the Geo here. Great way of showing that there's secrets around here. But yeah, so we met Quirrell. We know that he is motivated by finding secrets. Aha. Check this out. The gates have closed shut on us. You didn't spawn? Oh, we have two more. Oh. Yeah, we know that Quirrell is motivated by the sense of adventure. We know that because he commented on how drab and dreary it is upstairs, and he complimented people, or he, you know, mentioned people admirably who came down here to explore, and he mentioned something to the effect of he can't resist. How can anyone resist? So that tells us a little something. So it looks like we have... Is that a mask piece up there? Yeah, there's a mask piece up there, and we can't quite make this jump. So we need an upgrade before we can get that. We need to remember to be on the lookout for secrets as well. Here we go. And we've also met Conifer, and we met him, and he is interested in making maps. He talks about how in his youth he, you know, when he was hatched, he went off immediately, leaving his mother and his siblings behind to go out cartographing, and why he's here as well. So we know what he's all about. Let's go ahead and get ourselves healed up. We actually generate a bit of soul whenever we hit someone. Dangerous. Alright, let's head back up there, because I believe we can get over to the other side. Yeah. Ah, interesting. Oh, I deserve that. Totally deserve. Ah, I don't think I deserve that one, though. Alright. Yeah. And the worst thing is we don't even have any soul to regenerate our stuff. So we have a symbol up here. We have no way really of interpreting what that is, but we... Like, this is going to be a stag beetle station. So if we go over here, we get introduced to a new buddy. The music stops, so we get a bench. We know that this is a safe area because of that bench. Then as we go over here, inspect. A tall machine with the symbol of a stag. Insert Geo? Sure. We do that. We ring the bell and wait for it. Hello there. Greetings, little one. It's been an age since I last heard the ring of a station bell. It echoed down the stagways and called me to you. I've grown stiff and tired over the many years, and I've forgotten much, but the sound of the bell will always call me back. These stagways stretch the depths of Hallownest. If you want to travel them, hail me from the platform. I will take you to where you need to go. So yeah, we can actually head back to Dirtmouth from here. Yeah, let's go ahead and head back to Dirtmouth, because Conifer told us that his wife has set up shop up at Dirtmouth. Can we speak with him as well? This place. We're near the surface, I believe. There's a town here. You should take the opportunity to rest. This place was once full of travelers coming and going. It seems much quieter now. So yeah, we learned that this place was once a place of greatness, and based on how other people talk about it being a place of greatness in the past, and based on the narrative that we've seen as well, like the piece of narrative dialogue that tells us that Hallownest was once great. You get to travel the stagways? Just hop up upon that platform and give me the signal, and we'll soon be on our way. Mm-hmm. Here's the last stag as well. Man, that must be lonely. Alright, and here we go. This should open up one of the doors that we... Hello? There we go, okay. There we go, we have one of the doors open now. The stagway is unlocked. Elderbug, do you have anything to say?
I never thought I'd see such a thing. The stag station has opened. That building lay silent since before even my time. Oh, I've heard the tales of the glorious lines. A web of tunnels running all through the kingdom. Not that I'll be travelling them, mind you. Another reference to the past and how things used to work. I'm quite content where I am. A young couple's recently taken up residence in the house beside the station. Seems they're running a map shop, which may excite adventurer types like yourself. She's a tall bug, the wife. I told them to take a larger house, especially given they're all empty. But they liked the look of that one. The way she had to bend just to get through the door. I wouldn't put that up with that myself.
All right. Let's give Elderbug some company and let's go check out this house. He's already done some decorations, I see. All right, let's head on inside. Hello there.
Bapanada.
Come to buy a map, have you? It's really my husband you should be dealing with, but what a surprise. He's heading down below. He'll pop back occasionally to deliver new maps for the store, but I do wish he'd spend a little more time up here. I've not much interest in retail myself. Now, let's see what's here for me to sell. Alright, now we can actually start picking up some stuff. We have 284 Geo. Let's see, what do we have access to? The Wayward Compass. Highly recommended if you're having trouble finding your way in the maze of ruins below us. Try this charm. It will pinpoint your location on your map. Okay, we have the Quill. You'll need this if you want to update your map with new areas as you explore. Okay, we definitely want that. Bench pins will show you the benches. Cocoon pins. Have you seen those beautiful blue cocoons? I made these pins so you could keep track of them. Okay. So those are the... I believe they're the blue bugs that give you blue hearts. Right? Vendor pin shows you the shops. Stagway pin, hot spring, scarab marker, shell marker. We can just use these as waypoints. Okay, I remember. You could use this color to remind yourself of hard-won battles. This color is quite soothing, don't you think? Yeah, so we can just place those two wherever we want. Hot spring pin, stagway. I believe the compass will be fine, but I think I really want the quill. Let's pick up the quill and let's save for the compass. Can I talk to you? Of all the places to end up, we picked this dreary town. I thought it was a temporary stop, but then my husband became obsessed with that old ruin. Now he's spending all his time down here. He argues cartography is sound business, but other than you, who's buying? Right? That's exactly the question I had earlier. Are you enjoying yourself down in the ruins? At times, my husband makes Hallownest sound a wonder, but sometimes it seems ghastly, even dangerous of a place. Alright. Yeah, it's pretty dangerous, honestly. I do wonder how he manages to survive. Alright, let's head back down and bond with our old pal, the old stag. Alright, let's head to the Forgotten Crossroad and let's continue our adventure. Ooh. Don't forget to do your stretches. Okay. Go ahead and rest here. Oh, now that we've got the quill, he even pulled out his thingamabob. Here's a quill that we just bought. Attention to detail like that is a sign of a really good game. Oh, we heard another one of those guys as well. And what do we... we have another one of these guys. Okay, let's go. Ah! Don't get greedy. Don't get greedy now, Charles. Just remember the pattern, and don't overachieve. Okay, lovely. Is that not the same guy? No, that's not the same guy that we killed earlier. Get ourselves healed up a little bit. Yeah, this is a new-ish area. I don't believe we've been on this map before. Another thing as well, I'm not sure exactly what it does, but it's consistency in the enemy patterns, right? For more Dark Souls-ish games, I feel like that is essential. Uh-oh. I believe this is a boss fight. Ah. Not a boss fight? Ah, it is a boss fight. Okay. I was wondering when you'd show up. Okay, how do I fight you again? Okay, and then you do one of those. I remember that. Okay. Okay, okay, I'm remembering. The muscle memory is coming back. Okay, we got him. There we go. I remember thinking this was so hilarious the first time. Ah! Ah! I remember thinking it was so hilarious the first time I saw what he was on the inside. But that he's called the False Knight. And now he seems angry. You know, that implies a lot of stuff, right? Like, look at how big and intimidating he is versus how, like, cute and innocent and hilarious, honestly, he looks on the inside. That tells you almost exactly what you need to know about this guy. And if it's not quite clear to you guys, it seems like he's more of a weakling on the inside, and he's using his armor to try and be someone who, you know, he really wants to be, but he has not been accepted as. I'm also getting that from the, one from his expression. Listen to how, like, angry he is. Oh. Yeah, there definitely is sadness to him, I think. Okay, we got a city crest. Let's see. How do we access? There we go. Stone slab bearing the crest of the Hallowness capital city has an insert on the back that would fit into a slot. Oh, dude. Okay. Why does he have this? He is from the city. He was rejected. What the? The ball of his mace was an insect? What? Okay. So creative. Okay, cool. Let's go ahead and get ourselves some money. But yeah, like, it's just storytelling like that, where it is the reader that puts it all together, right? I think that makes this sort of game, right? It makes all sorts of, like, you know, Souls-esque games the way that they are. And I can't cross this gap anymore. Yeah. Okay, sure, whatever. And we can't quite climb that yet because I don't believe we have wall jump. Although we might be getting an upgrade here. Or... Okay. We're heading somewhere. Oh! Sorry, I missed you. If you're feeling lost, why don't you pop up to our store in Dirtmouth and purchase a map of this area? Available now for an excellent price. This is a shortcut. Lovely. I can't quite remember. Yeah, look, the floor is made of masks, similar to the masks that we wear. And honestly, that all... Yeah, take a look at that. What did this tell us? Like, it's obviously off-putting. And it's just the simple imagery that these masks are being used in shamanistic, like, displays, right? We even have these, like, things in the foreground here that are blacked out. Almost making it look like there are us, like, being crucified or put on poles and such. Alright, we head on inside. There's a rest bench here. So this is interesting. I believe if there was no rest bench here, people would think that this guy is an enemy. No. But the bench kind of signaled that this is a safe place. Oh-ho! Who is that creeping out of the darkness? My, you're looking grim. Strange. A strange, empty face and a wicked-looking weapon. Something important has drawn you down to Hollowness corpse, but I won't ask what. Perhaps the reason you found me is because you need my help? Say no more, friend. I'm going to give you a little gift. A naughty little spell of my own creation. It's perfect for a little one like you. Oh, ho, ho. Oh. Don't be afraid. Have faith. That spell belongs to you now. All you need to do is take it. Oh ho ho, you won't be going much further without it, I promise you. Almost as if he knows how the game works. Ooh. That is not good. Vengeful spirit. Tap B to unleash the spirit. Spells will deplete your soul. Replenish soul by striking enemies. So this is the very first upgrade that we get, and it looks like he's taken us somewhere. I love this. This is great. He only gets up when you put in a button command. Oh-ho? You were working at last. I apologize. Perhaps I should have warned you about the power of that spell. I was watching over you as you slept, but you seem to have slipped away myself. Oh, but seem to have slipped away myself. Now we're awake. I was wondering whether you would do me a small favor. Not as repayment for my gift, of course, simply because we're now friends. Are we friends? You presumably saw me fall unconscious and move me over here. You see, a horrid great beast has made its home in the heart of this temple. Such disrespect. I would be quite grateful if you were to venture deeper into it and slay it for me. It's a hardy creature, but with your new power, you're more than a match for it. Good luck with your small favor, my friend. Oh ho ho. Why didn't he do it? What is it? Are you wondering about this gate between us? Oh, it's a curious thing. But this door will not open unless you have slain the creature lying in the heart of that temple. Don't worry about it. I'm sure the spirits of my ancestors will be watching over you. If this door only opens with the death of that creature and you haven't killed him, how did I get in here? I guess that's the implication of this thing, right? No, even then. Alright. An isolated demonstration of how to use the spell. We get introduced to a new roly-poly enemy. Alright. And yeah, this area is just very off-putting. We have someone here who insists to be our friend. He also... What's the word? He gave us an upgrade, although said upgrade also knocked us out and he moved us into a suspicious place, right? And now he's basically forcing us to do his little quest for him. Need to watch that recoil on hitting these creatures from the side. Try not to hit the spikes at the bottom. Alright, we have a pathway over here we can use. Ooh. Yes, please. And it keeps on going. We don't really need to kill all these guys. Oh, and we have a blue bug thing. Okay, that's very good. Hey, get back here. Okay. We climbed over the top here, and yeah, now we need to head down this way. Okay, and this is the nasty creature. Hopefully at some point he's going to send out one of those things, yep. Easy peasy. And we pick up the Soul Catcher. Equip a charm to activate its powerful abilities. Okay, and we can only do that while we are on a bench, is that correct? Charms. Yeah, we can only do that while on a bench, it seems. Hello there. Oh ho, so it's done then. You've slain the beast. The poor thing. It must have been terrified of you. It used to be quite docile, but the rancid air in these caverns filled it with some ancient rage. Still, you did what had to be done. You have my gratitude, of course. We both know you wouldn't have made it through without that spell of mine. Oh ho ho. And look, the gate between us has opened. I'm sure you're eager to move on. Farewell and have faith, whatever you're seeking. It will find you. So, yeah, this is where I start to think, at the very least. That this guy is more of an eccentric helper. Like, sure, he tricked you. And sure, he forced you to do the thing that he wanted you to do. But, you know, he gave you a new ability. He let you go. And he did open the door, as he promised. I can't remember if that's the last time we see him. Anyway, now that we have this ability, a new area has been opened up to us. There is an area nearby where... I love that it's pulled still here. There's an area nearby that was blocked off by one of those creatures, and I can't exactly remember how to get back to it. Oh, but now we can do... Oh, I don't have any soul. Ah, come on. I wanted to use the new vengeful spirit thing, but we didn't have the soul to use it. Ah! I got greedy! Remember! You can't fight this guy with greed! You can only fight this guy with patience! Ah! Literally... Literally my fault. I went in for 3 instead of 2. I believe it's also a very Dark Souls-esque thing, isn't it? That whole thing with, like, being greedy against fighting an enemy, right? Doing more than, you know that you can. Very surefire way to get punished. Oh, come on. Come on. And if you're greedy like that, then you will take damage. And if you're too greedy... then only bad things will happen. Ah. How does my spirit get up there? There we go. That's how you do that one. Lovely, okay. It just looks so good, doesn't it? Oh, there's another game as well that I've just been reminded of. Axiom Verge. Ah. Oh, I remember these bugs now. These bugs were terrible. They're the most frustrating bugs to deal with because they shoot out in like a 3-fan situation. So they shoot out one bullet in front of them and then another 2 at like 45 degree angles from each other. From the first one, should I say. And that is really difficult to... surprisingly difficult to dodge. When you're also trying to dodge other things. There again, now that we've got that opened, we can head back up. That has been a shortcut that we just got. Ah! What on earth was that? Okay, so we can't move on from there. Okay, fair enough. I believe we need to unlock the lantern in order to get through there, or at least in order to get the sight required to go through there. Okay. Alright, so we're just gonna try to head back up to Dirtmouth for now. Oh, we can actually use this, right? No? Do we actually need the wings to get that guy? Oh, come on. I'm good at this game, I promise you guys. I'm just out of shape. Absolutely not copium whatsoever. Alright, Dirtmouth is just back up here. Lovely, we are close to the surface. I think literally just the screen and then we're done. Oh. Here we go. Let's go and see what's been happening up here at Dirtmouth. Alright, maps have been updated. I used to think the kingdom below were all dead cold rock, but I've since been told different. Travelers speak of startling variety in... Hollowness Caverns. Even just besides those crossroads, there's meant to be an area filled with leafy greenery. I told those same travelers about the wonderful grasses that grow around town, and they didn't seem impressed. Alright. Let's take a seat, and let's head back to Cornifer's here. Hey there!
Bapanada.
Yeah, she's her. We get introduced to her as someone who is fed up, or at least really doesn't enjoy the current situation they found themselves in. So sure, let's pick up the compass, I think. And let's also get a bench. Let's see where the benches are. Alright, and let's take a look at our map. So we have... This is what we've explored so far. So we came in from the King's Paths. We have Dirtmouth over here, or Dirtmouth. Ancestral Mound. Oh, was that, that boss icon there next to the Ancestral Mound? At least the skull. Is that the boss that we fought, the false knight? So if we head back to that big ladder room, you're right there in the center of the screen. Let's see. Okay, can't use my mouse. Excuse me. We can go to the second from top left. Actually, no, we can't. Where was that creature? Right, do we have to go all the way down to the bottom? And to the right? I think so. Let's go and check that. Ding. Alright, let's head to the Forgotten Crossroads. I believe it's not too far away from here. Let's see. Forgotten Crossroads. Yeah, this is the only bench here, so it's got to be this place. And if we just head down a little bit, we should be able to get there. Uh-oh. Ah! Don't poop your babies on me! Alright. So it should be down here, I believe? Try not to get hit by that man. Oh, have we not actually been down here? We have not. It's this thing. Yeah, it's not gonna let us pass unless we attack it. Grease, mother. Oh. She's not a happy lady. Ah. Oh, come on. Okay. Oh, now's not the time for heals. Okay, now's time for some heals. Yeah, there we go. You're gonna blow up. Almost reminds me of the Fistula boss fight from Isaac, honestly. While Fistula doesn't, like, necessarily blow up when you defeat it, it does split into other creatures into other versions of itself. Honestly, the best way of fighting these guys is just to bounce on them. Someone... Alright, let's leave him to his thing. Enter. Oh, hello there. Oh, you wield your nail like a club. Esme, how much deeper do we have to go? Oh, what? What? Who are you? I see. This old village. What a strange dream to have led me down here. If you hadn't found me, I don't think I would have ever woken. I'm Sly. I usually live an uneventful life up in Dirtmouth. The air in these ruins doesn't agree with me, so I'd best be getting back. If you return above, come and see me. I'm probably the friendliest face left there, and I can thank you properly for your good deed. Oh, you're exploring then. Very brave. Plenty of courageous wanderers have been lost to the hunger of these old caverns. You have your nail, though, and I can tell just by looking at you that you know how to wield it. Alright. So we have saved Sly, who I think is the general store guy. And we have unlocked a shortcut there. And I believe that is everything we can do down here. Yeah, over this way is where the charm guy is. But we can't quite use him just yet. I suppose we should just try to head on back, try and find our way. Let's see, where are we going? We've got a crossroads. So I believe we're down at the very bottom right. Let's go and check the very bottom left this time. One of these directions has this creature in it. And it's not this way? I must be going crazy. What is that? That's a sign that we're heading to a town? Or at least a... Oh, dude. Oh, come on. Okay, well, that's the way into Hallow Nest, I believe. The city. But we can't quite access that because the lift isn't working. Somebody closed the lift. And then they snuck out. Why don't we just fit in through the bars? Alright, come on there. There we go. Actually, this... Where do we... Is the exit up on this side? Yeah, okay, cool. Alright, let's go ahead and take a seat. Try and restore our stuff, and let's have a check to see what we have going on. Yeah, okay, so we have identified these areas. It looks like there's also a minor area. Can we zoom in even more? I don't think we can zoom in anymore. But there's a minor area in the middle of that long pathway that we were just at, that goes up. Might be something that we want to go and grab. I think what I'm going to do. So I actually don't have work this weekend, this week. So we can go on for a little bit longer than 2 hours of the stream. And we'll see how much longer I go for. For now though, I do want to take a bit of a break. Because I've been doing this for, what is this? Over an hour. And I just feel like I need to move, right? This would be a good chance for everyone else to go ahead and get themselves a drink. Go ahead and get themselves something to eat. You don't need to pause the video because I'm literally just going to be on break. And yeah. I will be right back.
Thank you.
Alright, hello again, ladies and gentlemen. Let's hit this transition button here. Hope you all had a good stretch. You went and got something to eat, said hello to your pets. Went ahead and got something to drink. I have some apple juice here myself. Can never go wrong with some apple juice. It is delicious. And delightful. Alright, let me just get myself situated here. Oh, I feel like I'm a bit further away from the camera than I was before. Is that true? I kind of wanted to get my whole head in. There you go. That okay? I think that looks okay. That should be fine. Alright, let's wake up our little buddy here. And let's be off. Okay, so where did we want to go? Am I unmuted? I am unmuted. Fantastic. Let's head up to this next elevation thing in this room that we're in. Ah, oh, come on. Alright, and it should be up here. Let's check to see if this is where our guy is. Ah. The way that we get these guys is we attack them from the top. Is that the rail car I got? Hold on one second, actually. Is this the right screen? Wait, why doesn't this look right? Hold on a second. I felt like my face was bigger before. No, this is right. I am using the right overlay, right? I don't think anything has changed. Hold on a second. Are we in the right place? I feel like we've been here before. Oh, surprise babies! Oh, there's a way over here though. Is this a secret? Yeah, this looked like a secret of some kind. Oh, we get another baby friend! Meemaw! Alright. We need to rescue all the Meemaws. Any of you watched that Pokemon movie that has Zora in it? I'm reminded of it because Zorua calls its mother Zoroark Meemaw or something like that, right? Is that actually a thing that people say? Is that a term that people unironically use? Or was that made up for the movie, I wonder? What is the strangest way that you've heard someone refer to someone else? I feel like Meemaw is definitely up there for me. A door with an open slot. Yeah, I'd say Meemaw. I'm sure some others will come to me. I'll give it a think throughout the stream. But I feel like that is... Yeah, we're not getting through there. Ma? For mother? Ma? Like, it's not strange. It's just something that I notice and I'm a bit taken aback by whenever I hear it. This takes us back to where the mother was. Yeah, okay, that takes us through to there. Cool. So let's head back this way. Actually, let's just head back up from the top, right? Is that the best? No. We should head back down from the bottom. Papa, I guess? I mean, Papa is, like, normal, right? Though I do feel like it's a little bit, childish of a way to refer to someone. Ma, I mean, I guess like, you could say the same thing about Ma, right? I'm not trying to insult anyone here, I'm just trying to figure out how I feel about some of these phrases. What are some of the more strange, Oh, come on. Yeah, I hate these guys. I guess we don't need to worry about him. Freaking flies. Okay. This will lead us over there. We could try to see what's on the other side over here. So let's check it out. I believe that'll lead us to roughly the fungal waste or the deep nest. Oh man, but we're gonna have to go all the way through, right? Sure, let's give it a go. Ah. But yeah, I have never heard of Mimor since before I saw that Pokemon movie. Though I feel like it is an American thing. I wonder what they say in Japanese. Does Zoroa still say Mimor in Japanese? One thing that I grew up with was, in terms of, like, the titles we use in the family. So I called my grandma, Grandma, right? I know, grandmothers can also be referred to as nans, nannies, and I'm sure other things as well. That might be a more British thing, calling them, you know, your nan or your nanny. But one thing that I noticed that my parents did is whenever they were talking about my grandmother, they would refer to her as grandma, right? Even though, like, to them, it's, you know, it's like my mother's mother. So she would know my grandma as, you know, mum or ma or, you know, something like that, right? But every time they were talking to me about, you know, my grandparents, they would say, like, hey, your grandma, where am I? Am I in a new place? This will lead me up to a hot springs, it seems like. Let's check out the hot spring. There should be a bench here as well, right? Oh, lovely. We get our soul replenished. Nice. There is a bench. Alright, where are we? Oh. Okay, here we are. Okay, so that area up there led to a hot spring. That is good to know. We want to continue on going to the west. So yeah, I've always called my grandmother Grandma, right? And I remember once feeling very strange when I was with my friend who was visiting their grandmother, but they always called her their Nan, right? And he's like a total Brit. Like, he's one of the Britiest Brits I've ever seen. And his family as well. And it weirded, like, the 11, 12-year-old me out so much that even I called her Nan, right? Because even, like, his parents were calling her Nan as well, right? Nan, Nana. But I think the other strange thing that's making this weird for me, right, is... Wait. That's literally it? Oh, no, I missed... We're meant to go down one, I see. Oh, come on. like, members of my extended family, they, I don't see my extended family too much. I was born into, like, the Dark Horse side of the family, right? I'm pretty sure they call their, you know, their mothers and fathers, like, Nan, right? At least when it comes to the older generation. Oh. Where am I? Okay, yeah, I still need to move aside. But, so, is that normal? Is it normal to call, like, your mother and father, like... well, I guess it'll only be your mother, right? To call your mother Nan? Okay, yeah, I need double jump in order to access that. But we can go down... Oh, I guess this is it. We should also be trying out some false walls as well. Almost forgot that those things existed. So yeah, and another question is like, what is the male equivalent of Nan? I don't think there is one, is there? Alright, we've explored this area. Where to next? Let's head up to the north if we can get there from the room beside us. So that we can explore some of those rooms as well. And if you hear a crunching sound, that's just me pressing the controller buttons down on my controller. The movement buttons, the joysticks? I think that's the correct way to say it, the joysticks. One second, let me go ahead and do that there. Okay. Oh no. I feel like streamer brain is definitely getting to me here. One thing that I remember, one thing that I took away from therapy, I think this is the correct way to go. Yeah, it is. But I do need, I do need some of your little ones to fuel my soul. Okay, shoot out another one. Thank you. One thing that I took away from therapy at one point that my therapist said to me is we were talking about overcoming social anxiety and identifying some behaviors that that I do whenever I'm feeling anxious. So that'll be things like bouncing, bobbing your leg up and down, fiddling with something in your hand, those types of stuff, which I'm sure like a lot of people tend to do, right? But what she mentioned is that if you're doing that with parts of your body, that is literally taking away brain power from you. You're allocating like a specific portion of your brain to her. You're allocating a specific portion of your brain to doing those things. So that means you're literally not being fully attentive towards whatever work that you're doing, right? Whatever task that you currently have. But at the same time, it feels a bit strange to say something like that. Because, sure, you might not be needing, that part of your brain may be preoccupied with this stuff, right? But what does that part of your brain actually, give you? Let me move this down a little bit. I feel like my chin is leaving the screen. But like, what part of the brain is it that uses your, that bobs your leg up and down, that takes away stuff from your attention in the moment, right? Like, surely that part of the brain isn't in use otherwise? Is that how that works? I feel like it's not how it works. Because I'm pretty sure there's a lot of research about, noticing things like this. I guess biting your nails is a different thing. I was going to use that as an example of what people do, right? But I'm sure anyone listening to this can understand what I'm trying to express here. And that's that. And if you hear fireworks outside, it's Diwali over here right now. People are celebrating the Festival of Lights. Probably not being picked up on the microphone, honestly. I'm just picking it up just in the background here. I freaking love this area. Look at this place. This area and the Queen's Gardens are things that I really want to have inspire my... That I really want to have inspire my, the elven portion of my, my D&D world, Elvenor. Just look at this place. It looks so good. Oh, Well, we got another little shrub bug here. We got another one around here, right? No? Okay. No more shrub bugs. But I feel like if you're doing things like that, I don't really know how to explain or express it, honestly. Dude, this area is so freaking cool. Look at that. Look at that in the background. That is incredible. Oh man, just listen to it. It's so peaceful, isn't it? Oh man. Ooh. Place is so amazing. Oh, that's right, we don't have the map for this area yet. Get a little geode node down here that we haven't been able to pick up. Did we come in from this direction? Yeah, we did. But one thing I will say is it does feel like it's, you know, being used to try and distract you when you're doing such a, you know, repetitive motions. Or we have our friend. Hey buddy. Oh, there goes the only friend we'll ever have. Well, not the only friend. Oh, the recoil knocked us back. Okay. All worth it for some geo. Give me that geo. But yeah, I do wonder what the science is around it. It does kind of take you out of the moment a little bit, right? I feel like a conversation that you have with someone where you're not, like, bobbing your leg up and down, and you're not preoccupied with like, other stuff, can lead to a more whole experience? I say that as a question mark, because it's not really something I paid attention to. I've only just recently been dawned onto this fact, or clued into this, idea that, you know, bobbing your leg up and down, or other, what is it called? There's a term for it. Avoidant behavior, I think. But how is it particularly avoidant if you're bobbing your leg up and down, right? In like a conversation or something like that? Or, you know, fiddling with something in your hand? But it's definitely something if you find that you're doing this stuff a lot and you have like anxiety and social anxiety and such, I'd recommend paying attention to what you're physically doing when you're uncomfortable. So something I've noticed that I do when I'm physically uncomfortable is I do start like moving my leg around. So let's say I'm sitting on a chair in like, you know, the workroom. Can I push this? No. But let's say I'm like sitting on a chair in a workroom and trying to talk to someone, right? Or somebody says hi to me who I'm not sure. I'll turn around, I'll say hi to them, I'll, you know, look at them, I'll smile, you know, all the regular stuff. But I'll notice that my foot starts moving around, right? So if I like sit cross-legged, my foot starts moving. And I've noticed it. I don't know what it necessarily means, but I imagine that it means, you know, I have a bit of anxiety about talking, right? And it's such a mindless activity as well. It's incredible how, you know, your body does things that you're not aware of. You think you're in control of this bloody thing that you've been living in for, like, you know, the past however old you are. But no, it still does stuff, like, that you don't expect, right? That you think that you would have control over, but, you know, you don't. That's just wild to me. It's like, how have I not noticed over all these years that I do X, Y, and Z? Oh, we have map friend. Map friend. Hey. Isn't this a contrast from the crossroads?
Such a humid, lively place. The roads twist and turn in the most wonderful ways. I've done my best to chart the area ahead, though I must admit some of the area's inhabitants proved quite a nuisance.
Purchase a map? Absolutely, we're purchasing a map.
I ran into another traveller as I made my way down here. I tried to call out to her as she dashed past, but she barely even glanced in my direction. Not an appreciator of maps like you and I, obviously.
Obviously not. We can also hear a little friend somewhere. Although... yeah, I can't fire this thing upwards. And it seems like... yeah, we can't quite get over to there. That's okay. It sounds like that's another... bug friend. Is this the way that I came? Yeah, it is. Alright, let's see what's down here. I believe... is it the Green Path boss? There's a boss that I really like. Let's see if we can get both of these guys. Hello? Oh, come on! Standing in exactly the wrong place. Alright, so we have the Green Paths. Ooh, and he has mapped stuff out for us. Lovely. Yeah, let's head on over this way. I believe that way near the bench that is unmarked, that is where Hornet went. Ooh, what is that? You see that over there? He drew something. What would that be? I can't remember. Let's check to see what's over here, though. Ooh. Ah!
Tiny Squib, you approach fearless. Are you a hunter like me? Do you feel the urge inside to stalk, to kill, to understand? Then take it, my journal. It will aid you. At first, the text may seem difficult to discern, but a learned hunter will come to understand its words. Venture the depths of this land and slay its beasts. Prove yourself worthy to bear the mark of hunter.
Oh, he just friggin' spit that out. Okay then. The Hunter's Journal. To open the yeah. Alright.
Little Squib, you may have overcome a few creatures, but you are only just beginning. Don't delay. Descend into the belly of this world and hunt down the life you find.
Alright. So we have the hunter. Do we ever actually get to see what the hunter looks like? If not, then I hope that's something that we get in Silksong. But yeah, which one is the Mantis Lords the boss of? Is it the Green Paths? Wait, no, something else is the boss here, right? I can't quite remember. Alright, are we missing anything else here? We might be missing something at the top. Like, on this level. Ooh, more Geo. Of course we will take that. Let's go ahead and heal ourselves up. And is this a hidden path? No. Alright, and that is... yeah, no, okay. Yep, no hidden wall there, no hidden wall there. Okay, we can head down into this area now. Let's give it a look-see. Oh! She's so freaking cool. Oh wait, no, isn't Hornet the boss of this area? Oh, come on. Yeah. Ooh. Those who stray from the White King's Road shall face the Law of Un. Interesting. The Law of Un. The White King's Roads. What did that say? From the White King's Roads. Why are they punishing people who stray from the White King's Roads? What was that? Was that Bug Dog? Ah! Okay. Can we get a journal entry for killing this guy? No. Okay. So where am I heading now? Yeah, still to this direction. Get rid of that guy. Go ahead and just pop him like a zit. Ah! Oh, amazing. We can't quite make it up there, huh? These little guys sound so cute. But like, what's actually here? Nothing? Wah! Oh, it's so satisfying pushing them into the acid. Ah! I guess I deserved that one, huh? Oh! There she is again. Ooh, there's an up. Are you gonna blow? Alright, let's head over this direction. Oh, yeah, we're getting zappers. I feel like... How would we... Yeah, we can get through that, I think. This part here might be a bit tricky. We might... If we bounce... We might hit the top. We might need the sideways dash ability to get through this. But let's give it a go. I think that's the gate for letting us know that we need the sideways dash ability. Yeah, let's give it one more go. If we can't get across, then that's fine. Nope, okay, let's head on back. So we know that this place is here. We're probably going to get that after we beat Hornet. And if I remember right, we actually do. Okay, we need to heal up. Oh, come on. He hit him inside the gas. Inside the spore explosion. Ah! I thought that was a beginner's fly trap. Oh my goodness. Okay. No secrets there. Fair enough. All right, we have another bug dog in the wall. Dude, those bug dogs are so cool. I want one. Okay, we're back in the city. Where is this taking us? Ah, we're climbing the thing. That's a trap. Yeah, if you look real closely, you can actually see the spikes on the ground. I feel like Venus flytraps are one of the most prominent fantasy-based plant creatures. Especially when it comes to carnivorous creatures, right? I think I've been here, right? Yeah, let's head on back in this direction. And let's head back down. Easy peasy. Let's go ahead and get our spoils of war. All right. Dude, the area here is just so lovely. I adore it. What makes this place so good? I mean, the atmosphere, the artistic atmosphere is just amazing. The music is also what we have to go by, the enemies as well, and another aspect of it's going to be the platforming that we have to do, right? You can characterize this in terms of platforming as well. Are we really gonna head down here? Yes, because this is where Hornet went, right? I believe Hornet is... Oh, hold on. Yeah, Hornet is up there. So Hornet is gonna lead us up there, but there was a gem down here. Or something we can pick up. I see. Well, we can't actually pick that up. Oh, how unfortunate. But yeah, she is definitely luring us somewhere. I wonder why. She knows that we're not the only person down here. There are others like Quirrell and Cornelius. And Cornelius ran into her already. Okay, there is a bench up there. Was there a... There's not a side path down here. Fair enough. Man. You really gonna make us pay for it, huh? Not like we don't have the money. Whew. Alright. Lovely, lovely. Ooh. All right, here we go. I'm trying to think of a good topic to talk about here to fill some of the dead air. Though the only thing that my brain seemed to be focused on is talking about, funnily enough, social anxiety. I don't know why that's funnily enough. I guess that's a... I don't know. Ooh, lovely. I do have a question of the day currently set up. Yeah, we've been this way. If you type in exclamation mark question, it'll ask you, what the question of the day is today. And the question of the day, let me go ahead and put this in. If we do exclamation mark question, did that not work? Why did that not work? Hold on, it's meant to work. Oh, with a capital Q? Okay, let's not make it so pedantic, right? Let's just make it normal Q. Alright, let's see if that works. Exclamation point question. It's not working. Interesting. Also, where is my chat box on this screen? Yeah, chat box is over here. Strange. Try it again. Question. No? Strange. Okay, I have no idea why that's not working. I will sort that out though. I'm just going to do a quick test message. Huh, yeah, for some reason the chat box isn't actually... Oh, there we go, now it's showing up. Lovely. It doesn't comprehend, or it doesn't show anything that starts with exclamation mark, it seems. Alright, let's get back into this game before we... Yeah, I think I need to climb to the top of this thing. But yeah, the current question of the day, it actually, how do you guys start conversation? What is the thing that you use to, what is your go-to for breaking the ice, right? For me, I don't have something that I use to break the ice. Yeah, I can't make it over there. I don't normally have something to use to break the ice, which is, probably... a bit anxiety driving. Ooh. The greater mind once dreamed of leaf and cast they these covens so. In every brush and every vine, the mind of Un reveals itself to us. Is Un sort of like a religious creature? Oh, okay, here's a boss. Ah. Okay, that was surprisingly easy. I do have a little booklet nearby that has got a few things that you can talk about in. So it's sort of like things, like if I were to start a conversation with someone in chat, I'd be like, so what brings you to the stream, right? Would that, is that actually an okay thing to ask? You can see how confident I am when it comes to socialization, right? Honestly, it's part of the reason why I want to do things like streaming and such. It is to try and, you know... Did you hear... Was that in-game? It sounded like there was thunder. But yeah, part of the reason why I want to do streaming and YouTube and the like... although I don't really have too much time to do it during normal working days currently, is to try and get better at, you know, discovering myself, finding who I am as a person, and just generally being more comfortable with the conversation. Am I meant to be here? I feel like Hornet did not come this way. Oh, frickin', it's frickin' Zote! Hey, hey! Ah! Okay. Come on here, you bug. You are one of the bugs in this world. Soon to be X. Hope I didn't speak too soon. Okay, come on. Ah! Oh, you have ads, huh? Let me hit you with my magic. Remember, Charles, greed is not the way. Hey, buddy, you alright? Buddy? Oh. He's up. Just what do you think you're doing? You dare to come between me and my prey? Is it a habit of yours to scurry about, getting in the way and causing a bother? Know this, Kerr. I am Zote the Mighty, a knight of great renown. Cross me again, and you'll find out why they call my weapon Life Ender. Oh, Zote is lovely. What are you still bothering me for? I'm a knight. I'm not interested in your childish games. I need my rest. Be gone, lest I draw my nail. You know. Yeah. Zote is so cool. He is awesome. Okay, and then we pop on back down here into the green land. What is this, green path? Yeah. Alright, let's head on over to here. No secrets here. Uh oh. Oh, come on. Okay, yeah, no. We got ganked into a corner. Alright, where are we? So we're back here. Yeah, we died up there. So we need to head on up. Now I can't quite remember what I was saying. I remember talking about social anxiety. Oh yes, and why I want to do this. To honestly just try and, you know, speak more. Talk, be in more of a... I know this isn't quite, you know, the social environment or the best social environment to be in, considering, you know, the only interactions that you get are, oh, that's a term for it. Like, pseudo-relationships? I don't think that's the right term for it. But it's not a... Oh yeah, and we can't get there from this direction. But it doesn't beat, like, face-to-face, you know, socialization interactions and such. But I feel like this is a good middle ground. To some extent. Are you really gonna reanimate again? There we go. But I feel like this is a decent enough middle ground where, you know, we can explore things. Where I can explore things. Or like, not just me, but like other streamers as well, right? Where people in other streamers can get used to interacting with people, even if it is, like, in chat. I actually had, it was a rather anxious thought about meeting, some of the other streamers who I like to support in, like, a Discord call or something, like, being on call with them. They're wonderful people, and I hope that this doesn't come across as me, you know, saying that I don't want to interact with them. I do. They're, you know, pretty cool people. But, it's just, there is a sense of anxiety that comes with it, right? And, oh, one source of anxiety is absolutely the fact that it's never, you've never done something before, right? That's normally a source of anxiety, I think. Oh, man. So creepy. Yeah, so the trick here is to hit him so that he sweeps his... He does his front attack and then beat him up from there. Yeah, we need to descend a little bit. Jump over him. And then we can head on into here. And I believe this is the Hornet fight. Right? Oh no, isn't this where Long Leg Lady is? No, this is Hornet fight. Okay. Ignore me. Yeah, let's give it a go. Hi. Come no closer, ghost. I've seen you creeping through the undergrowth stalking me. This old kingdom, a terrible thing awakens. I can smell it in the air. I know what you are. I know what you'd try to do. I can't allow it. What are we gonna try and do? Oh. No fair, how come they hurt me when I touch them, but I don't hurt them when they touch me? Yeah, so we're, Oh, come on. I can't, Alright. We need to find a better place to camp. Let's go ahead and find that. But I think when it comes to exploring anxiety as well, it definitely, like, knowing what causes you anxiety is the first step, right? You can't figure out what you need to do in order to improve if you don't at least identify, you know, what you need help with. Oh, and I've mentioned on stream several times that another source of anxiety for me is in, funnily enough, Yu-Gi-Oh! Master Duel. Hitting the ranked duel button is terrifying to me. Playing on ladder and playing competitively, it doesn't even have to be Master Duel. I just use that as an example because that's one of the only, you know, competitive ranked games that I play. Or at least that I want to play. Usually my time in Master Duel is spent trying to fight the computer in the solo mode. Oh, come on, I can't get through here again. So yeah, definitely about knowing what causes anxiety in you, right? One day I'll get that guy without dying. But then it's another thing about identifying exactly what the issue is, right? Or like what we can do to improve it. For instance, I feel like when I face like ranked duel anxiety, it's better when I am like watching someone such as Nanami or another streamer doing ranked duels, and then I can also do ranked duels as well because I'm literally seeing someone else. And also when I'm on like a Discord call to someone else, I feel at that point as well is easier to manage, right? And I'm not entirely certain how that necessarily translates in, or what the equivalent to, you know, being on a Discord call is when it comes to, like, social anxiety. But one thing that I found with anxiety is things are typically worse when you're expecting it, right? So it's like going out and being a public speaker, and I always say this, which makes it sound a bit contradictory considering it doesn't seem to work for me. But that is, let's say you're preparing for a public speaking event, right? You're sitting down there, you're waiting your turn to go up and speak. You've memorized your speech, you know exactly what you're gonna do, but you're just waiting for your name to be called, right? So your name is then called and you go up. That, at that moment, it is the worst, right? That is the worst moment for anxiety. It could also be like before as well. It might be different for everyone. I can totally see someone being like extremely anxious the night before someone does a public speaking event, or they go out and do something that they are really dreading the following day. Usually the thing that you are dreading doesn't normally end up being as bad as you make it out to be, right? So for instance, going up and public speaking, all you're doing is just stepping on stage and you are saying what your point is. Those are literally the only two things that you are doing, right? It just so happens to be there's a crowd of people out there, and they are all listening to you because they want to hear what you have to say. And similar to like Master Duel, right? Where all you're literally doing is you're drawing a random set of five cards from your deck, and then you are playing them, and then your opponent does the same thing, and then you play back and forth until something happens, usually after turn two, and you know. All right. Hornet is gonna require quite a bit of attention here. Okay, so we can get her when she does that. We don't want to be above her all the time because she does like to jump. Ah! Oh, we got her! Ah, okay. Dude, the music is so good. The characterization is amazing. Like, we don't know who this chick is. We know that she's serious because she didn't entertain Cornelius at all, right? Okay, we can get a heal in here. Try not to squander it by... by missing your attack and landing on her. Okay, I think... we're getting some good hits in here. Okay. Oh no, I feel the pressure. Oh, she can wall jump! Okay, we got her. We haven't yet. Come on. I keep double clicking the button. We're safe from here. Ooh. Okay. Oh, we got her! The last hit. We got her. But yeah, what was she doing? Why is this thing here? Taken the Mothwing cloak. Press RT to dash forward. Use the cloak to dash quickly along the ground or through the air. Alright. RT. Yeah, that's the trigger. Alright. Oh! Would it seek to break the seals? They cannot be undone. They must be undone. Let us sleep, little shadow. Return to your darkness. Allow us our peace. What? Was that always a thing? Ooh, I just got a shiver up my spine. Was that a thing? Or am I just crazy? Had that always been a thing? Was that introduced in a later patch? I do not remember that. Yeah, and look at how much we rely on this now. Yeah. Okay, so we have a path this way. Let's head this way. Listen to how silent it is. After all that tension has been built up and we fought that boss, the music is just wound down. We had a strange lore moment. Ooh. Dude, this place is so cool. Lake of Un. Hello there, buddy. I feel like you're not a nice person. I'm just going to leave you be. Yeah, let's just, let's see. Yeah, we found the Lake of Un. I remember the Lake of Un. Hey there, Quirrell. Oh, hello there. Seems we both tread far from the path. I can hardly believe those dusty old highways led to such a lush and lively place. This building suggests some form of worship, though its idol has clearly been long forgotten. Doubled equally well for a moment's respite. I saw a strange fellow out there. He seemed quite taken by the lake. I'd planned to offer greetings, though I figured I'd first tend to my nail or on chance our meeting goes poorly. Your nail looks a fine instrument, but it's showing signs of wear. I would wager up there it would take you far. Down here, however, I suspect you'll soon meet dangers the surface world can't match. Hollow Ness is perfect for vigilant explorers like us. So tense and thrilling. In this place, you're either alert or you're dead. Alright. Krill's such a nice guy. Okay. Go ahead and say hello to our friend here. He's not really our friend. Ah! Alright. And yeah, sadly we can't quite cross the Lake of Un. It is actually poisonous. And we cannot swim. Even with our magnificent dash ability, it's not possible. But yeah, another thing that is like I find very unfortunate when it comes to managing anxiety, and I feel this is the same for a lot of other people. There are kids who I work with in secondary school over here in the UK who also have this same issue, but it's something that makes you uncomfortable, right? Is this the right way we go? Yeah. So they're trying to figure out how to say this. Yeah, I guess I'll just use the social example, right? In order to get better at socialization, how do people get better at socialization, right? Well, they go and socialize. It's literally the way that you practice. Socialization is a skill. Ooh. The green children walked from the dream unto these lands. Here we now shall wait, patient, for the call to return. Wait, let's read that again. The green children walked from the dream unto these lands. Okay, so there's some guys called the green children. They walked from the dream to here. And now we wait for the call to return. I don't know what that means or what that refers to. Ah, that's the wrong button. Oop. Yeah, I don't have the dark upgrade to this, so I can't... Oh. Ah, come on. Ah, okay. And it leads you into a trap, right? So let's say you're not good at something. Let's say you have great social anxiety when it comes to playing ranked on League of Legends, right? I feel like a lot of people can probably relate to that. Personally, I don't play League of Legends. I don't play any MOBAs. It's not really my style of game. But let's say you have anxiety when it comes to playing ranked on League of Legends, but you really want to play ranked on League of Legends, right? You have the game, you really want to genuinely get good at it. Yeah. You really genuinely want to get good at it, and you want to, you know, get better. You've seen other people play it, and you think it's a fun game, and you enjoy playing against the computers. But when it comes to ranked, you just can't do it, right? You have just this anxiety about it. What do you do to get over that? Well, sadly, and this is very frustrating, sadly, the way that you get over it is you have practice doing it. You play it until it doesn't become a problem anymore, right? But it's also more than that. It's also about understanding exactly what the issue that you have is, right? And that can be, that is like, you know, extremely challenging in its own right. Finally, we rescued the little one. Because your brain, like, your brain can't really pinpoint exactly why. Are you really trying to shoot me from there? The brain, like, doesn't know, right? Or it may know, but, oh yeah, here we go. I'm bobbing my leg up and down. I don't even know what's going on. I'm not, like, anxious or anything. I guess sometimes it doesn't need to be anxiety or anything like that. Nope. Where do we go from here? Yeah, let's head this way. So it's like, what is it about going into League of Legends ranked that, you know, makes it that you can't play? In my personal experience, I cannot answer that question. Like, I do not know, right? And I'm using it as a parallel for my experience with Yu-Gi-Oh! Master Duel. And with my experience when it comes to, you know, socializing in a non, what's the word, in a non-standardized setting, I guess, or an unplanned setting. Sorry, I need a bit of concentration here as I go through this. Also, just need to bring my thoughts to bear as well. Yeah, I've also lost what I was talking about just now. But yeah, like, I, for instance, can't really figure out exactly why... You serious? I see. Okay, this is gonna actually take my attention off. Take my focus anyway. So yeah, you have anxiety, you wanna try and get something done. You can't do it. You don't know why you can't do it, right? Everyone else seems to be able to do it. Your brain starts kicking you about not being able to do it, even though it should be so simple, right? And you can't literally see why you can't do, like, X, Y, or Z, right? Like, why is it that you can't go into the League of Legends ranked mode, right? When everyone else seems to be able to do it. It's like, I don't know, my body just reacts in this way. Right? My body just reacts with great anxiety. I literally do not know why. And it's like, okay, why is it? Okay, do you feel better when you play casual mode? Yeah, a little bit, but I still have it. Okay. So it might be because there's something at stake, right? And it's like, sure, but I don't really care too much about it. Is this the right way? Yeah. Sure, but, like, you know, it's not actually what you get from it is not really something that's meritful, right? Like, all you're getting is, like, you know, rank in a video game, right? It's kind of, and I know a lot of people can put a lot of people can put different varying amounts of importance on these on, like, something like this, right? Like, to some people, getting a rank is extremely important, right? To other people, it's really just like a thing you do in your off time. I feel like it's similar to why people on the internet can get very heated about certain topics, that it seemed like they shouldn't be getting heated about. Oh, sorry, that it seemed like it's not worthwhile to get so heated about, right? I feel like it's a similar thing there. But I can't really elaborate on that further, it's just a hunch that I get. Yeah, we need to cross over here. Oh, come on. Is this where we... Yeah, he's a little bit further ahead. And that can be frustrating because now your brain is preoccupied with trying to figure out why it is that you can't do this instead of actually trying to figure out how to do it, right? It's something that I see quite a lot in students is a student is like, hey, no, I can't, listen, I've tried this, I cannot make progress, and I'm going to finish my point before we go down here. So I work with a lot of students who are like, they may be failing in a subject or something like that, right? And they really don't understand why they don't get good in it, right? Like, for instance, English literature and English language over here in the UK. That's something that a lot of people with a special educational needs can have trouble with, right? Especially with people on the autism spectrum whose brains work quite literally. They can have a lot of trouble interpreting media and interpreting stories and non-literal language. So even if they have something like that, They may still struggle with it, and they do not understand why they can't do this, right? Like, they understand logically that, hey, this is meant to mean this, and, like, metaphors mean this, and similes mean that, and so on and so forth. And they go through these experiences. They're like, I can't work this out. I've tried, and it's not working. So I'm just going to, you know, not put as much effort into it, right? And why should I try when I've tried already and it doesn't work and anything I do doesn't seem to work? So I'm going to not put in the effort. So, you know, there's that. In that case, what's going on is twofold. One, they've given up, which is a really bad sign. And that needs rectifying, because a lot of being able to progress is the effort that you put in. And I feel like this is important and almost makes me feel a little hypocritical, because I do the same thing that they do in Yu-Gi-Oh! Master Duel and in socialization as to what they're doing with English class, right? Like, I'm partially deaf. I can't really hear people too well in a environment where there's a din around us, right? A sound of other people talking. So I use that as an excuse to not pay attention and to not go into social situations, right? At the same time, people who struggle in the subject, and not necessarily just ASD people, but just like anyone who struggles in a subject and can't really figure out why and they feel like they should, they need to defeat their defeatism about it, and they also need to stop focusing on the fact that they can't do it and focus more on what they can do in the moment, right? So the equivalent to doing it to, like, Yu-Gi-Oh! Master Duel would be, okay, I have extreme anxiety about going into ranked. All I need to do is click this button. Okay, button's clicked. Okay, what do I do now? Well, wait for a minute for it to find you a partner, and then once that's happened, you're going to draw 5 cards, right? And then after that, you look at your hand and you're like, okay, what card here is the best card to play in the situation with my deck? And then you play from there, right? But that is going to be very difficult if you're looking more long-term, I feel. Like, if you're looking more long-term, you're like, okay, I can't do a ranked game, right? I have a lot of anxiety playing ranked. When instead you can just break it down into smaller parts, and it's like, okay, can I press this button? No. Okay, what do I do? Try and wait there, and try and calm yourself down, do some calming exercises, and then see if you can hit the button again. If you can't, then, you know, don't force yourself to. It's okay that you can't press the dual button, right? And similarly, if you're struggling in anything in life, or that's way too broad. If you have anxiety that's holding you back from something, definitely try to figure out exactly what's going on and try to push yourself a little bit at your own time and see if you can work it out. But okay, let's focus on this for a little bit now. Yep. Ah. Okay, oh, we haven't got one yet. Ah, okay, I missed him. Wait, no, one of them died, okay. Interesting. I wonder if he still remains dead. But yeah, anxiety sucks. Anxiety is the worst enemy that you ever have to face in life, I think. I mean, maybe except for, like, you know, a devastating illness, perhaps. And you see, even that I have described all of this stuff to you guys about techniques to... Oh, come on. Which are techniques to help you deal with anxiety. Your brain can still use that against you. If you're, like, knowledgeable about this stuff, and you're... you can logic this kind of stuff out, and you still can't do it, that is... Oh, that is, you know, almost nigh unacceptable to your brain, right? And that's going to mean that you kick yourself quite a bit more. I might be speaking from my own personal biases here. But with things like this, it's important to, you know, air them out, I think. To try and come to, like, an understanding at the very least on what's going on. And even if you can't, that's fine. That's fine too. You don't need to have an answer for everything. There's a noise around here. Where am I? Oh, it's you. I feel like there's a worm around here. Oh, excuse me. Oh, if you've never heard any of my sneezes on stream, I just unleash sneezes left, right, and center. Oh boy, okay. So we are going to head back to where we left our spirit, and I think at that point we're probably gonna try to wrap the stream down. Ooh. I guess another source of anxiety that's a bit relevant, it had actually been stream anxiety for me. Well, I guess it's not too much of a bother, right? But it is like, oh no, am I going to do a good job? Is anyone going to watch the stream? And it's not really, honestly, about that, even though, you know, oh, you want to do streams to have other people watch? Excuse me. Oh, come on. Oh, man. I've got the hiccups now. I think that might be a sign that I've been talking too much. But yeah, it's like, you know, stream anxiety is like, oh, but I don't have anything lined up or to prepare and speak about. And, oh, what about dead air? The boulder shell. Oh, that's, I give defense, doesn't it? Shell is not indestructible and will shatter if it absorbs too much damage. Protects its bearer with a hard shell while focusing soul. Ah, yeah, okay. So while you're charging soul, you can get that. Cool. Don't know why the music is still going on here. Right, is there a bench here? Nearby? No. Okay. Ah! Oh boy, okay. Alright, we can charge a little bit of soul, so we're not one hit away from death. What's down here? Yeah, we have a safe platform over here. And I guess that's gonna be it for this section, huh? Literally... Wait, that's on the other side of the King's Pass? Wow. Alright, let's head back down to the bench, and then let's see... with only one viewer, I don't think a raid is going to be necessary, I think. Well, but I do believe our good friend Nanami is streaming. We'll take a look when we get to this bench. If I remember where... Oh yeah, the bench is down there. Here we go. Whew, alright. So let's go ahead and quit to the menu and let's see. Let's take a look here. Users in chat. Hello there to the users in chat. I hope you all have been enjoying the stream. I don't actually know how many of these are bots or who are not connected to the stream itself but are in chat. I don't even know how that works. Let's see. I am just gonna give a shout out, I think, to someone who is streaming who's in my Twitch sphere. Let's see, once this loads for me. Oh my. Yeah. So the usual suspects The Hedge Witch is streaming. Nanami is streaming. Nanami is just chatting. Nanami has also recently reached 300 subscribers. So if anyone is here watching that, go ahead and check her out. She is at twitch.tv/Nanami00. Let's see. The Hedge Witch as well is playing Tetris 99. They have been... I don't think I've actually caught up too much with them. But yeah. All right, well, anyway, I hope you all have had a wonderful time here. This has been my first stream in a while. So yeah, I hope it has been enjoyable for you guys. Oh, I am glad that I did the stream. I wanted to play, let me see if we have 10 to, oh no, I paused Final Fantasy 10. Because of the problems we were having earlier on in the stream. Yeah, but expect to see Final Fantasy at some point soon. When I say expect, like, it's on the list, I think. That's not actually an official list. Normally how I decide what games I want to play is I decide on the day. I'm still not that organized. I think my stream is taking a bit of a step back in recent times because of some new obligations at work. As well as not really having too much time to myself. So streaming in the future on this channel is gonna it's still an evolving process. I still want to stream. I still want to share. I also need to get used to looking at the camera. I'm so used to looking at my face here. But I feel like looking at the camera is a lot more personable. But yeah. Still working everything out when it comes to stream. I know I've been streaming for like months at this point, probably over a year now, or half a year, I think, since I started streaming back regularly, right? I'm gonna have to check that up. But it's a slow process. That's fine. It's fine to proceed at whatever pace that we need to proceed at. But yeah, I hope you all have had a wonderful time. Let me go ahead and just give a shout out in chat. Oops. Well, so here we go. Let's do twitch.tv/nanomi00 for not TB, TV, please. And then we also have twitch.tv/thehedgewitch. Let's see if I actually got that right. I'm gonna pop into their stream briefly here just so that I have the URLs correct. The Hedge Witch? Yeah. I'm typing this in chat. Check out our friend Nanami. Check out our friend Moss. There we go. So yeah, the Hedge Witch channel is streamed by Moss. They are a great person, a great artist as well. And yeah, those are really, I feel like every time we stream it's either one of those two, isn't it? I want to try and expand my Twitch circle here. I actually follow a lot of people who do Master Duel. Let's see, another one that I can shout out is Little Miss Hound Doom as well. They have very high production quality in their streams. It is incredible. I would highly recommend going to check them out. But yeah, I am going to go ahead and do these two in here so that you guys can check that out on stream, and so that it's there in the YouTube channel as well, in the YouTube VOD. But yeah, hope you all have had a wonderful day. I hope your day continues to be wonderful. And if it's night, I wish you all a very good evening. Alright, everyone. Hope you all take care. Let's go ahead and get the stream ending screen up. Alright, next stream will be on Thursday. I may do an additional stream tomorrow because I have the time. I need to figure out what I want to do on the stream, though. But yeah. All right, have a good one, guys.